us to stop police brutality, repression, and the criminalization of a generation. Today, in more than 30 cities across the country, people are taking to the streets like we are here today, holding panel discussions, cultural events, and in other ways, standing up and saying no more. No more the police brutalizing and murdering people and getting away with it. No more to the government unleashing its repressive apparatus against people who stand up against injustice. No more to treating our children like criminals, guilty until proven innocent, if they can survive to prove their innocence. We created this October 22nd National Day of Protest back in 1996. And if anything, it is even more relevant and more necessary today than it was then. Just look at what's happened in the past few months. Every day I get up, I go online, and I check it, and there's a new case of police killing an unarmed, innocent person. These police are almost never punished for these crimes that they commit against the people. You got people like Herman Wallace, a brother who spent 4 decades in solitary confinement in that prison in Louisiana. They finally overturned his conviction and let him out 3 days before he died. Other people have spent decades for standing up against injustice. Immigration raids are going on at a record pace. Raids that tear families apart and disappear people. And we have the verdict in the Trayvon Martin case. A verdict that said black people have no rights that white people are bound to respect. That not only will our cops treat you like criminals, brutalize you and murder you and get away with it, but now we got ordinary wannabe cops who can go and do that and get away with it. This is what's been going down. But also, these things have begun to impact people. We saw people take to the streets in outrage across the country after the Trayvon verdict. People expressing questions about the injustice and the unfairness of this system. This is the time to move, to tap into that sentiment, to tap into that anger, to bring out to people, this shit happens all the damn time, and it will continue to happen until we stand up and resist it. We have to fight back around this stuff. We can give heart to people who suffer this day in and day out, that they can stand up and resist, and that others will have their backs when they do it. We can open the eyes of many people in society that these horrors that they think happen only every now and then are everyday occurrences that impact the lives of millions and millions of people, and that they need to join in to deal with that. We can impact that, sisters and brothers. Now, we have to understand that this hell that the criminal injustice system brings down on us, not just the police brutality, but the warehousing of millions of people in prison, treating people who have been in prison and gotten out like they're less than full citizens because they used to be in jail, all of that is part of what I call a slow genocide that is strangling black and Latino communities all across this country. It is built into the fabric of this system, sisters and brothers. It's just a new form of Jim Crow segregation and lynch mob terror, which was the new form of slavery. This stuff is built into the fabric of this rotten system, and I will tell you, it will take revolution, nothing less, to get rid of it once and for all, to deal with these problems, and not just the police brutality, the criminalization, but the violence against women, the wars for empire, the way that they're devastating the environment, all of it. Because this world we live in, it is an absolute horror, sisters and brothers, but it does not have to be this way. Through revolution, we could end all of these horrors and bring into being a society that people would want to live in. Because I'll tell you, we should live in a society where those who are entrusted with public security would sooner lose their own lives than kill or injure an innocent person, which is exactly the opposite of the way these cops, these pigs operate in this society. They brutalize us, they murder us, and then the system...